If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS and you cannot afford to make payments to the IRS, you may qualify for the CNC Tax Program. This is a new program, and if you qualify, you won't make any payments to the IRS while in this program. Once you're accepted into this program, the IRS is forced to stop all harassing collection activities. No threatening phone calls, no wage garnishments, no bank levies, and no more monthly payments to the IRS. Get ready to write this number down. It's the most important number you'll ever need to end your IRS tax nightmare. Call Paramount Tax Relief at 800-547-4804 for a free confidential consultation to find out if you qualify for the CNC Tax Program. Once you are accepted into the CNC Tax Program, you won't make any payments to the IRS while in this program. Call Paramount Tax Relief now at 800-547-4804. That's 800-547-4804. Again, 800-547-4804.
Okay, folks, at just a skosh past the top of the hour. Hello and welcome once again. Jones here on the USA Radio Network. We are so glad to have your attention, your kind ear, and the use of your mind. Because let's face it, radio, wonderful thing about radio, it's like an idea rifle. You load up an idea in a particular break and send it out over the airwaves. And if you're within listening range, you can't avoid it. It's going to change you. It may make you think. It may make you mad. It may make you glad. It may make you smile. It may make you sneer. But radio produces intelligent input. Now, of course, it has to be intel in to have intel out, we hope. But then, as my producer says, stuff on the radio can make you smarter and make you dumber. I've got to tell you, of all the things I expected to see when I was told that the so-called squad, the circular firing squad, I call them the goof squad, of Rashida Tlaib and AOC, Ayanna Pressley, and Ilhan Omar, they sat down for a full segment interview on CBS This Morning, Gayle King sitting in, where they basically doubled down on Nancy Pelosi and warned her again of singling out women of color. They're expecting differential treatment, special treatment, because of who they are. Oh, some of them have been getting death threats, and they're just so terrible, it's just so awful, wah, wah, wah. Then they say that they're absolutely willing to meet with Pelosi. Really? She's the Speaker of the House. You are freshman congressman. She calls the shots. You run the show. She says jump. You say how high. You shouldn't expect special or preferential treatment because of the color of your skin, nor because you're women. Now, clearly, that's what you expect, and in some way, shape, or form, well, you'll see what I mean here in just a minute, because my producer has been very busy. He had to sit through that entire interview, and some of this stuff is just plain amazing. I want you to hear, and this will take about a minute and 20 seconds. It's quite something. Check this out. Here's the squad sitting down with Gayle King as she tries to reason with them, and toward the end of this clip, you're going to hear them say something amazing. You're going to hear them say that, why, if Nancy Pelosi wants to come, she can meet with us if she wants to. Really? You're gonna grant her an audience? No kidding. And you'll hear them say that they expect preferential treatment by virtue of the fact that they're women of color. They are freshman congressmen. They are there to do the bidding of the speaker, and the level of conceit, flippance, and you'll also, they sound like high school girls. And they're back and forth. I've listened to this twice. I find it completely amazing. Here's the interview Gayle King did with the four horsewomen of the apocalypse. And you'll hear Gayle King try to reason with them. And what the energy you hear from them, they sound like high school girls on a field trip to the Big Apple. Check it out. Here we go. On the USA Radio Network. It played perfectly a minute ago, and now it's giving me a hard time. This is so annoying, I can't even believe it. And it just played, and it won't play now. It just played perfectly, and it won't cotton pick and play. Well, we'll try cut two and see.
Congresswoman Tlaib, do you regret it was your first day, and you called the president of the United States? You said, we're going to impeach that MF. Mm-hmm. Do you think that that kind of language is helpful, and what did you hope would come of that?
No, I mean, from day one, I truly believe that he has committed impeachable offenses, and me. You know,
but even if you believe that, the fact that you called him.
But I didn't do it on the House floor. And I'm going to be unapologetic in myself. 70% of Americans curse. I'm real. Mm-hmm. This is who I am. I'm rooted in where I come from. And it's very common for me and for many of my residents to say things like that.
But so you don't regret that?
Absolutely not. I'm unapologetic about it. I'm definitely going to push forward and saying we have to impeach him.
So no matter what I do, no matter what I say, the story is not about me. The story is about him because he's some kind of a. Well, it's OMB. It's Orange Man Bad, Orange Man Bad, Orange Man Bad. And by the way, here's a question. The papers of impeachment presented by Congressman Al Green from Houston was voted down overwhelmingly by the Congress late yesterday afternoon. And the question there is this. If the Congress has considered impeachment, and they had a small discussion slash debate about it, I presume, and it was brought to a thing and voted on, and it was voted down overwhelmingly, then why continue to argue, agitate, otherwise negotiate for impeachment? Why do this? If you can't get your own house in which you have the majority to vote for you, then clearly those of you who are talking about impeachment are kind of out on the end of things. Let's do some of this. Once again, Gayle King tries to ask a question and gets, well, you won't believe what she gets. Check this out.
But on paper, you do not have the votes for impeachment. On paper, you don't have it. So what is the point of going through the exercise of impeachment when it doesn't look like it will go anywhere?
The Watergate class didn't have the votes in the Senate side. They didn't function from that place. They function in putting the country first, and they function in doing what's right.
Ayanna?
Gail, if that were true, then we might as well just pack it up and go home.
Yeah, you might as well.
Leading and legislating on everything from gun violence prevention to climate to consumer protection. Why are we leading and legislating and moving bills out of this House when they are not being moved in the Senate? You know, this is about our demonstrating a strength of conviction and acting on these issues of consequence to the American people. How many times did Senator Kennedy look to advance health care? So, you know, ultimately the victory, sometimes the victory is in the fight.
Sometimes the victory is in the fight. Well, let's think about this. The founders, at the point of the founding of this country, designed a system that would move slowly. They understood one of the biggest problems that the Greeks had in crafting the first real national democracy in the combination of city-states that became classical Greece. The Greeks understood that they needed democracy. The problem they had was the tyranny of the majority. The majority would vote one way one month and another way another month, and it moved so fast, it tyrannized, it was not stable. The founders separated the powers, kind of like a three-legged mixture, legislative, judicial, executive. And they did that so no particular part of this government they were creating would be able to overpower or tyrannize the other part. And also, they wanted the system to move slowly as people made up their minds, because they understood that the faster government moved, the bigger, more constant, and sometimes more serious the mistakes would be. So the very thing these girls are talking about doing, about speeding all this stuff along, and we're going to fix this and fix that and fix this, the system was not designed that way. And if you knew anything about the founding, you'd understand how it was designed to work. And I think you might be, shall we say, a lot less frustrated. I wonder if I can make that the second part work again. No, it's so frustrating. And Google does this from time to time. Let me see if I have a trick I might be able to do to play this first part, because the first part is so important. All right, let's see if we can't make this work here. Now, you have to hear this. When you hear Rashida Tlaib saying that they'll be happy to take a meeting with the Speaker of the House, girl, you got the cart before the horse. The Speaker of the House calls the shots in the U.S. House. Let's give it a shot here and see if we can make it work. Yeah.
Are you speaking to Nancy Pelosi?
Here we go.
You mean right now?
Yeah, exactly. Well, you're speaking to me right.
Did you hear what she said? Are you speaking to Nancy Pelosi? And AOC goes, like right now? Gosh, she's such a dipstick.
Here are you speaking to Nancy Pelosi?
You mean right now?
Yeah, in general. Well, you're speaking to me right now.
Our teams.
But in general, are you in communication with her?
Our teams are in communication. Our chiefs are meeting.
But shouldn't it be a face-to-face with
I
you
agree.
And the speaker?
Yeah.
As opposed to, as opposed to your people and her people.
Right.
Shouldn't
right.
it be a face-to-face
but,
with
but
all
we're
of
missing,
you?
I think, we the bigger
new, But we are new
point.
Members of Congress.
I know, but
look,
I want
we
you
are
to
new
answer
members
that question.
But no. I'm very protective. So once
she doesn't, no, she no, does not need protection.
I know that
she really.
But this is
why she knows
how to handle
herself.
If you didn't know what the source of this audio was, wouldn't you think you're listening to some kind of high school debate class, some sort of student legislature? This sounds like high school. But wait till you hear Rashida Tlaib here in just a moment. Comes in about 20 seconds.
I don't think
that
we should
personalize.
She doesn't. Wait a second. With all due respect, she doesn't need protection.
Right.
I want to know if you are
She's
speaking.
She's the new member, not the speaker.
No, but I want to know.
She has every right to sit down with her in any moment, any time, with any of us.
Yeah.
She is Speaker of the House. She can ask for a meeting to sit down with us for clarification.
She is Speaker of the House. She can ask for a meeting. Are you kidding me? She can ask us. We may deign to grant her a meeting. We may not. I am not believing what I'm hearing here, but it continues.
The fact of the knowledge is, and I've done racial justice work in our country for a long time, acknowledge the fact that we are women of color. So when you do single us out, be aware of that. And what you
acknowledge the fact that I've done racial justice work. What is that? Can you get a major in racial justice work? Can you get a certificate? Can you get a lesson plan for that? And acknowledge that I've done racial justice work and acknowledge that we're women of color. We want to be treated special. We are who we are, and you have to treat us like stars. Man, this has gone to their heads. It's unbelievable.
We're doing, especially because some of us are getting death threats, because some of us are being singled out in many ways because of our backgrounds, because of our experiences and so forth. But I think
Alexandria,
the question
are you interested
be
in having a conversation face-to-face
oh, absolutely.
With Speaker?
So, dig us, we're special, we're women of color, we're freshman congressmen, and if the Speaker of the House wants to have a meeting, she can ask for one. We might grant it, we might not. The level of conceit, the arrogance. I had postulated earlier in the week that it was the combination of ignorance and arrogance that is dangerous, because in the case of ignorance, you don't know what you don't know. In the case of arrogance, you don't care about what you don't know because you think you know everything. So it's impossible, if you have those two items running in the background, to learn to come from a position of humility and understand what there is you don't know and come to the people that do know these things that have been where you haven't been that can teach you the ropes. It's called being a journeyman, being an apprentice. There's lots of different things you can call it, but these girls are not any kind of a candidate for any of that. I just find that remarkable. It's just amazing. Anyway, phone number 844-RADIO-US, 844 Radio U.S. Have you ever heard anything like this? And CBS gives them almost an entire hour. Mr. Producer, how much of that tape did you have to cut up? How long was the show? 33 minutes. CBS gave them 33 minutes, almost around. If you cut in commercials, that's almost an entire hour of television. And they, I bet Ms. King wished she was drinking. Jeez. We'll have a couple of interesting numbers for you in just a moment. Stick around. 844-RADIO-US. Jones here on the USA Radio Network. Be right back.
I used to wonder when I saw people going into nice hotels, really nice hotels, taking a pillow with them. That was before I got a MyPillow, because I know it doesn't matter where I'm going. Whether I'm going to a 1-star, 3-star, 5-star hotel, MyPillow goes with me. Whether it's just overnight or whether it's on vacation. And here's the great deal about MyPillow right now. The lowest price ever offered on radio or TV. 2 MyPillow premium pillows for $69.98. That's only $34.99 per pillow. The lowest price ever offered on radio or TV. And it's still the same pillow. Great pillow. 60-day money-back guarantee. 10-year warranty. And call them. 1-800-951-8175 or Go to MyPillow.com, use promo code USA, click on the two-pack special, and get the best deal you've ever gotten on a good night's sleep when you get a MyPillow.
Everyone loves liberty, so why are you letting other people tell you what's best for your health care? Exercise your freedom with Liberty Health Share. Liberty Health Share is a community of people who voluntarily share one another's medical costs. Members are able to take back the freedom to make their own decisions about their health care. Stop letting others tell you what to do. Call us at 855-58-LIBERTY for more information, or check us out online at libertyhealthshare.org. That's libertyhealthshare.org.
Hi, I'm Wayne Allyn Root, the conservative warrior. My show, War Now, airs every day right here on USA Radio from 6 to 9 Eastern, 3 to 6 Pacific. I'm also the star of the Wayne Allyn Root Show on Newsmax TV, reaching over 50 million homes. And I'm a number one best-selling author of conservative books. But my favorite role is speaker extraordinaire. I was the opening speaker at many Trump for President events. I addressed over 40,000 patriots at the biggest Tea Party in the history of America. Sarah Palin and I addressed over 20,000 at the biggest Tea Party rally in the history of Nevada. I speak at Republican, conservative, and college GOP events all over this great country. And I'm available to be the star at your next event. Contact me now to arrange for a Wayne Allyn Root keynote speech or master of ceremonies at your GOP event, fundraiser, banquet, campaign rally, or college GOP event. With me as your keynote speaker, it'll be the biggest hit ever. Just call toll-free 888-444-ROOT. That's 888-444-ROOT. Or email wayneroot@gmail.com.
Every hiring manager knows that a company is only as good as the people it's made from. So where do you find the best people? That may surprise you.
Meet the grads of life. Young adults of unique determination and experience. An ideal fit for your company in an entry-level position, internship, or even mentorship. They might not have every qualification you typically look for, but they're exactly who your company needs.
This is talent worth knowing about.
Go to gradsoflife.org to learn how to find, cultivate, and train this great pool of untapped talent. Brought to you by the Ad Council and gradsoflife.org.
Does your business spend $500 a month or more on gas and electric bills? Did you know by making a simple free phone call, you can save up to 25% on your bill every month? What could you do with a 25% savings on utility bills every month? Energy deregulation is now available in your state. Making one simple phone call will show you how we can lower your gas and electric bills instantly, with no changes to your bill and no enrollment fee. This is a free service. The only thing you'll notice is a lower bill every month. Call U.S. Power and Light right now. Learn how easy it is to lower your utility bills for your business and save money. We promise. So if you spend over $500 a month on your gas and electric bills, please call right now and unleash your savings.
800-941-3381. 800-941-3381. 800-941-3381. That's 800-941-3381.
Are you struggling with addiction or alcohol problems? If you're depressed, drinking, and using drugs, you may need help. And the Affordable Care Act guarantees coverage of substance abuse.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
Call the Addiction Hope and Helpline now for a free assessment with someone who cares. Call 800-854-1055. 800-854-1055.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Call now for hope and help with proven, gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call the Addiction Hope and Helpline now for a free assessment with someone who cares. Call 800-854-1055. 800-854-1055. 800-854-1055.
So, would you be surprised if I told you that the House has already voted on impeachment? Indeed. Please remember, Nancy Pelosi did her very best to keep the House from considering impeachment. But a gentleman who I think has a lot more chutzpah than good sense, named Al Green from Houston, he's a congressman, he presented articles of impeachment. It's been a few days ago. And there was discussion. There was back and forth on this. And late last night, the House overwhelmingly blocked a vote to move ahead with articles of impeachment against President Trump. That's after Texas Democratic Representative Al Green introduced the measure. That would be Tuesday evening. The vote was 332-95. So that would mean that 427 out of the 435 congressmen were present for the vote. And if it's 332-95, 332 against 95-4, that would mean that most Democrats in the chamber voted alongside Republicans to table and not further consider the measure. And that also means that only 95 Democrats in the House would have voted not to table the measure and support moving ahead. Now, the bottom line to all that is it takes 218 votes in the House, as it's currently constructed, to move forward on an article of impeachment. And if they only have 95, they're less than halfway there. Also interesting, I looked up who voted for what. The chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, Jerry Nadler, he was one of the congressmen who voted to move forward. And his committee would be the one to initiate impeachment proceedings should they have been approved, and he has not publicly said he would support impeachment. But I tell you what's interesting here. If they can't get enough people to consider impeachment, that's one thing. Part two, if they can't get enough people and actually return articles of impeachment against Trump and they go to the Senate, it's not going anywhere in the Senate. And I think there's a very good possibility that what you might wind up having is some kind of big trumped up, you should pardon the term, trial of Trump. But the Senate is supposed to have the trial, but I'm sure the yelling and screaming and finger waving and accusing that the congressman will do, because everybody gets their 5 minutes of time to show to the folks back home to fill the coffers with donation dollars. I mean, that's what that's for. They'll get out there and they'll do their very best. But there's a very good possibility that the evidence may be so thin and the conjecture so poor that they might not be able to support an impeachment vote in the House, in which case Trump would go to 2020 saying that he's been vindicated because he was attempted to try to impeach him and couldn't. And what I found interesting was when I heard that Green had introduced these articles of impeachment, when I found he'd introduced those, I thought, wow, man, he's telling Pelosi to go fly a kite. But apparently, he said late yesterday, on Wednesday, that Pelosi had not discouraged him from introducing the articles. Of course, she's not stupid. She can certainly count. She knew good and well that they were going to pass. And I think she thought that some of these guys blew off some steam and things would pretty much go back to where they were. So they're going to bring these articles of impeachment before the House again. Because they just don't want to condemn him. They want to impeach him. They want him to understand there are boundaries. They want Trump to learn a lesson here. I think they're going to have a tough time with this. And especially given the fact that Nancy Pelosi, it looks like she's lost control of her caucus. And certainly CBS News is not helping her any by giving such a gigantic chunk of time to these four persons. And if you haven't seen their sit-down with Gayle King on CBS, you really should. And the headline over at Twitchy, the squad sat down with CBS Gayle King and basically filmed the Republican National Committee's next ad for them. And I think they're right. But when they say that Pelosi is Speaker and she can ask for a meeting to sit down with us, she can ask for one, that she has to acknowledge that you're women of color and be aware of what they're doing because we're so important. Man, this is not going the right way.
Do you wish you could get better sleep and maybe lose a few pounds? Maybe more than a few pounds? Well, there's this product called Calitrin that helps with both sleep and weight loss. Just listen to what people are saying about it.
I've been taking Calitrin for right about 3 months, and I've lost 24 pounds and 19 overall inches. But my sleep has improved, I have so much more energy, and I have the desire to succeed more than ever. Anyone who needs weight loss, more energy, and better sleep, this product really does deliver.
I'm Roger. Over the 3 months that I took the product, my sleeping habits are increasingly much better. I got a better night's sleep, and I just can't say enough about the product and how it makes you feel. Also, additionally lost a little bit of weight on the program as well.
Hi, this is Aronson. I take Calitran for weight loss, and I've lost about 20 pounds, and I feel great.
Calitran is scientifically proven to help with sleep and weight loss safely and effectively. Check it out at toploss.com. That's toploss.com.